The barriers to entry to YouTube are crazy high. You compete against people with $10,000 or more of equipment.
In today's episode, we talk about Casey Neistat being right about YouTube. Casey Neistat is so right, and John Redinger of Techno Buffalo is so right. Techno Buffalo is saying that in YouTube, when you're starting, you have to compete with people using $10,000 to $12,000 worth of equipment. So that is what I believe YouTube is all about nowadays, putting out the most highest quality cinematic videos you possibly can. But I also agree with both those YouTubers that said you have to put out the highest quality video or no one's gonna take you serious.
Is it worth starting a YouTube channel now in 2018? My answer for that is yes. If you were to ask me, can you make a living on YouTube now in 2018? I mean, the answer is still yes. There are so many more very good, kind of high quality YouTubers that are on this platform with the purpose of making a living. It's a lot harder.
So after having walked back to the bank to get money out so I can go on the pier, and no sir, I'm not a surfer even though I look like one. And that's one thing that I do like doing is filming. Peaceful thing you can do is go watch the surfers or just hang out and enjoy the sounds of the ocean. But I'm about to bounce because I didn't bring any suntan lotion and I don't want to be out here just getting cooked, because if you notice, I'm extremely white and I don't want to just turn into like a lobster. you guys just pretty much experienced a little bit of what Jacksonville Beach has to offer. It's not a world famous beach by any means. A lot of surf competitions, a lot of surfers come out here, and you have a lot of surf shops. That's pretty much what Jacksonville Beach is all about. Other than that, there's really not much that goes on here besides all the beach bars and people partying and people have a great time. So my question is, if you guys don't like the beach or the ocean or the springs, then what are you doing in Florida? Because Florida's all about the beaches, the springs, and all that kind of fun outdoorsy stuff, especially in the summertime. Because in the summertime, the humidity rises, it gets way more hot, way more humid, and it's just the way of life in Florida, basically. If you live near a beach, typically you're down at the beach. Typically you're hanging out at the beach, you're watching surfers, you're enjoying the festivities. But I'll say this, I'd rather go to the ocean, not at like 11 o'clock in the morning like I did today, but typically like 6, 7 o'clock at night, and you go, wow, that's kind of late. No, actually, there's still people out there, and it's a lot more cooler, and you're not sweating your ass off as much, and it's just that much more fun or exciting. Or I like going at sunrise because it's less quiet, and it's just very, very relaxing because you're not there just sweating buckets. Because here in Florida, if you're at the beach, you're always sweating bullets. Haha, if you know that reference, let me know in the comment section below. Sweating bullets!